It doesn't matter if you pay for Trello or if you're just using a free Trello account, you now have unlimited access to power-ups. That's right, you can use as many power-ups as you like. So in today's video, I'm sharing with you 7 great Trello power-ups that won't cost you a thing. And let's dive right in with Crmble. Many people have asked me, Scott, can I use Trello as a CRM system, as a customer relationship manager? And I'm often hesitant to say yes, because Trello really wasn't designed for a CRM as the end goal. Until now, with the Crmble PowerUp extension, you can use Trello as an excellent CRM system. Now, when we first open up a Trello card, you can see that we have some Crmble fields, which allows us to enter in customer information. Now, you can customize which of these that you want to display or even add some of your own. But here you can see I can add in all of those details that I'm used to seeing when working with a traditional CRM system. So whether this represents a new client or a deal, I can move it through its different stages of the sales process or the pipeline or however you'd like to set up your CRM and have that information accessible here. But you can also see on the front of the card, I can see the size of the deal. I can give it a rating. I can see if this particular client or this lead is warm or not. Maybe it's a little cold like this one here. But it gets even better. If we click on the Crmble link here in the top right-hand corner, we've got our full CRM dashboard. So I can see exactly where things are within that process. I can even click on the leads option here, and I can see all of my customer information here all in one place. So if you want to use Trello as a CRM system, be sure to check out Crmble. Now, the next free power-up on my list has almost become standard for all of my Trello boards, and it's called bulk actions. How many times have you wanted to make changes to multiple cards right here within Trello, but Trello doesn't allow you to do that? Well, with the bulk actions power-up, you can do just that. Let's say that I need to change 3 cards in 3 different lists, and I need to change their labels. I want to change this one, and I want to change this second one, and I also want to change this third one here. Well, I'm going to waste an awful lot of time by clicking on each and every one of those cards. But if I select bulk actions at the top of the screen, it's going to show me a slightly different view of that Trello board. But now you can see I've got these little checkboxes. So if I click this one, and this one, and then this one, now I've got all of these options available to me here. So in this case, I want to relabel. I'm going to select relabel, and let's say I want to make sure that they're all changed to an HR project. So I'm going to say relabel. I can say relabel and keep selection if I want to do further changes on these 3. Why don't we do that in this example? I'm going to select that. First, it's going to add that blue HR label, but they've remained selected because maybe I also want to change their due date. So I'm going to select their due date, and I'm going to say that everything here is due by the end of next week. I can even make that time nice and uniform, and I'm going to say change the due date. So now you can see not only do they all have the blue HR label, they are now all due on September 3rd. Bulk actions is such a massive time saver, no matter how you're using Trello. Now, no matter what you use your Trello boards for, sometimes you may have a list or more in which you want to keep in check. And what I mean by that is perhaps there's a part of your phase that you want to make sure that you don't have too many cards at any given time. That's where the list limits power-up comes into play. Here you can see under my pending list, I've got some numbers at the top. It says 3 of 4. Because I have list limits enabled, and I've told it I only want a maximum of 4 cards in this list, it's going to give me a warning if I exceed that number. So let's say, for example, I'm going to drag over this card into this list. You can see it says 4 of 4, and maybe one of these in progress cards I have to bring back. So I'm going to bring it back to pending. Now, not only does it tell me it's 5 out of 4, but this entire list is now shaded in a different color. So this is telling me and other members of my board or that, wait a minute, we've got too many in this pending state. What's going on? What's the bottleneck? What do we need to do differently? Now, you can apply these list limits and change the number for any of your lists, or as you can see in my example here, you can just apply it to one particular list. So don't feel that you have to apply this to everything in your workflow. Now I can say that, you know what? Maybe we can still work on this particular task, and now that color changes back to its normal shade, I can still see the total, the 4 out of 4. If you need to add your list limit, all you need to do is come up here and come down and select set list limit once the power up is installed, and now we can set our number here and say save. Now I can see it's 3 out of 5 for this in progress list, and I can continue to work with my Trello workflow. Now, when it comes to managing all of your tasks and cards, setting a proper priority can be one of the most effective ways to get the most out of Trello. You're probably familiar with using labels, where you can use labels not only for different categories or perhaps departments, but you can also use them for priority. So for example, here I've got a red urgent label and I've got a yellow medium priority label. But sometimes this can get confusing because I also have things like departments and other categories mixed in here. Well, now you can use card priority by screenfall to set a true priority. Here you can see on a few of my cards, I've got things like highest, and I've got one here that is labeled critical. And these are separate from the labels themselves. If I open up this card, for example, you can see that it has its own client request label, but it also has its separate priority level. So under power-ups, I can select card priority, and here I can choose or edit the priority levels given here. Now, these are the defaults that card priority gives us, and I think they're most helpful. If I want to bump this up to highest, I can do so. It's going to change it here. It's also going to change that on the front of the card as well. And if you select the card priority option here in the top right-hand corner, it can also give you a summary of where those levels are and where they exist amongst your different lists. In fact, you can even look at a few different ways, based by label or by assignee as well. Now, the nice thing is under settings, you can really customize this power-up. So for example, maybe you don't want to see it on the card front, but you do want to see it on the card back, or vice versa, or maybe both, as we see in this case here. The other nice thing is this option to only show the high priorities on a card front. You very well know that by adding more information, maybe other custom fields, maybe other power-ups as well, the front of a card can get very, very busy. So I think this makes an awful lot of sense, that maybe we only want to show the top two priorities. We can still give these other high priority levels or these priority levels to other cards, but we don't necessarily need to show them everywhere. If I uncheck this option and hit save, you'll see that I have a few more that appear because these are below my top two priority levels. But if I ever need to come and change that, I can do that here under settings. I can also come in here and actually change the text of any of my priorities as well. So a very flexible tool, a great way to add true priorities and not waste all of your Trello labels. Now let's stick with another power-up designed by Screenful, and this one is called Card Dependencies. How often have you been working within a Trello board and you know that something is a parent of something else, or maybe this task is a child of another card? Maybe something needs to be accomplished before something else can get started. Well, with Card Dependencies, we can do that. Let's open up this card as an example here. So if we want to add a dependency to this particular card, all we need to do is go over to the power-up section and click on dependencies. And here we have a number of different ways in which we can add a dependency. So for example, maybe you work in blocks, meaning that it is blocked by another task or it's related to something else. In this case, I'm going to say it's a child to something. So I'm going to select that option here. And now all I need to do is search for the name of that other card. So in this case, I'm going to say it's a child to new idea two. What's going to happen is I'm going to have its own card dependencies section right here, so I can see the relationship between these two. The other nice thing is that it's quick and easy for me to remove if need be, or to check it off, so that once this connection or this dependency no longer remains, I can check it off at this level. Let's add something else here just as an example. I'm going to click on dependencies here, and in this case, that's a child too. I'm going to say it's also a parent of a different card. So in this case, I'm going to say this is related to something called a new listing. I'm going to select that one, and now you can see the different relationships here as well. The other bonus of using this power-up is that we have direct links to these other cards. So if I click on new idea two, I can go directly to this other card and see what's happening here. And if I need to go back, I can see that, oh, this is a parent to get quotes from new vendors, and I can go back to that original child dependency. So a great way to make and see those relationships between your cards. Now, the next power up in our list has all to do with getting more out of due dates right here within Trello. Of course, applying due dates is so crucial to staying on track and making sure that your projects can complete on time. But sometimes it can be difficult to estimate how far out is this particular date. And if you've included both a start and an end date, how long is this actually going to take? Well, with the card duration power up by Placker, it can give us both sets of information in a different and more digestible way. So for example here, this card is due on September 3rd. How close is that? Well, down below, it's telling me exactly. That's in 1 week, 7 hours, and exactly 21 minutes from now. This is maybe a little more relevant to me, and as I glance at other cards as well, such as October 31st, okay, that's 1 week and a day. This is 1 week and 3 hours. Now I've got a bit of a better grasp of how close I am to those due dates. But if you've also included a start date, here you can see the card duration power-up will tell us the total amount of time. So this card should take us about 4 days in this particular case. This one has a very long duration. It's 27 weeks and 1 day. I wouldn't be able to do that math quickly in my head, but now I've got the exact number here thanks to this particular power-up. So if you're wanting to see this, not only on the front of the card, but you can also see this inside the card as well. Be sure to install the card duration power-up by Placker. Now, the seventh free Trello power-up on our list has all to do with tracking costs. Whether you're tracking a budget or financials here within Trello, Costello makes things so much easier. Even before I open up any of these cards, you can see here in the top right-hand corner, I've got a total cost of roughly $2,500. What it's doing is summing up the different cards where I've added cost data. So in this example, I'm going to come over here to the power up section, and I'm going to add a total cost. So let's enter in a number, something like $1,500. Now you can see I've got this number attached to this card here. If I close this and I come to the front of the card, you can see that that cost is visible here as well. But the great thing is that my total cost has increased because, of course, it's going to be dynamic. So I can add cost to any of the cards on this board. And when I click on this option here, I can summarize it by a few different ways. Not only will it show me the individual cards where I've added cost data and include the number, but I can summarize it by column. So here I can see my biggest expenses are under the pending task here, but I can also summarize it by label as well. So here I can see that both HR and the client requests are very close at around $2,000. So if you're working with money, budgeting, or financials, be sure to install the Costello Power Up. Well, I hope you enjoyed today's Trello tutorial and tip video, and I'd love to hear from you next. With unlimited power-ups for everyone, what's at the top of your Trello power-up list? Be sure to let me know in the comments down below. I hope you give this video a thumbs up and subscribe right here to the Simpletivity channel for more Trello tips and tricks. And remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.